Good morning. Are you people able to hear me? Asha madam, are you able to hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Now is it okay?
Yes, yes.
Yes, ma'am.
All over again. This is the third time. So let us see if we are third time lucky. Okay? So good morning. Good morning to our respected principal Asha madam. Good morning to our respected vice principal Deepa madam. Good morning to all my colleagues and a very warm welcome to the freshers. So this is the third day of your orientation program. On the very first day, you met with our Director General Abhiraman sir. And you also met the different units heads. So what did you understand by that? You understood that you have not joined any small little junior college. You have joined a huge institution. We've got various units. We have got a degree college. We've got a PG units. We even have a music college. So you join as a junior college student and you can finish even your post-graduation over here. Yesterday you met with our alumni, our ex-senior students. And my, we were really proud the way they spoke. Is it not how well they have done in life? So they are a mirror. They are mirrored for you people, for the freshers. That tomorrow you can also aim to be as successful, as confident as them. Okay? So today we are going to introduce to you, you are going to meet the staff members, the faculty members of our college, the people with whom you will be directly interacting. They will be your mentors, they will be your guides, and they will be like second parents to you once you start coming or when you join the online class. Okay? So we have very experienced, very good faculty here who are there ready to help you anytime. Okay? So to begin with, let us hear our principal ma'am. And now who is our principal ma'am? As you must have, you heard her yesterday, you have heard her day before yesterday also. She's Asha Rani madam. And she is the one we all will be following. She is the one who is going to spearhead the college. So we as the staff and you as the student will be following her. Okay? So let us listen to what Asha madam, our principal madam, has to say. Over to you, Asha ma'am.
Yes. Thank you, ma'am. Good morning to all. Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, good morning. Now, actually, what all I'm going to discuss with you all, you can remember the points or else you can note down the points if you have book and pen with you. Because today I'm going to discuss all the details of online classes. Okay, so if you can remember, it's fine, or else you can jot down the points which I'm going to tell to you all. And I request you all to mute yourself. Please mute yourself. Yes. Now today, I'm going to give all the details of how your online classes will be. Fine? So starting with the, like we have formed the WhatsApp groups. You all might be knowing about this. And we have all the faculty members as the group in charge. So you will be receiving the Zoom link and that link will be sent daily to you and a day before. And you have to join the class on time. And for joining the online classes, what is required is mobile, tab, laptop or desktop. And you should have the proper net connection. You should download Zoom app. Are you following, girls?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
These are the key points that you need to remember for all the days. So you need to download the Zoom app today itself, if possible. And you should have your own access to the electronic gadget, let it be mobile or laptop or desktop. And you should always be connected with the WhatsApp groups because whatever updates are given, you should follow it. And make sure your name should be visible to us because what happens is if you keep another name, we don't know who that student is, who is attending the class. So the username, ID, what all details you put in for the logging and all. See that your details should be, make sure for that your details should be shown to us, like name and class. That will be good from your side. And your classes starts from Monday, the coming Monday, that is 12th of July, okay? And the timetable will be shared in your WhatsApp groups. Online classes link should not be forwarded or misused, because it is our institution and you belong to Bhadruka. So we have all ethical values with us. So better you don't misuse forwarding it to your friends or somewhere else. Okay? And if at all you are caught for all this, then certainly you'll be removed from WhatsApp group. Okay? And I have the confidence that you won't do such things. And try to sit in a separate room to avoid the disturbances while classes are going on. Because moreover, what happens? People, they play music, background music. They'll sit near television or music system, and that distracts us as well as you. So I prefer that you sit in a very silent, separate room so that you can concentrate whatever we teach. And when topics are explained, you can note down the important points. Okay, so maintain running notes. Maintain running notes for all the subjects so that you can review it later. What happens is, sometimes you don't remember the points, whatever is taught to you. So better you write the running notes, jot down the points, so that later on you can review it, revise it. So do it for all the subjects. Then whenever classes are going on, put your video on. Whether you're available or not, it should be seen by us. And you can mute yourself to avoid the disturbances. And whenever questions are asked from our side for any subject, you can unmute and you can answer the question promptly. We can see your names. We can call out your names. So you should be ready and alert with the answers. Okay, so whether it's a virtual or not, that is not the issue. Whether you're following our classes or not, okay, that we require. And be regular for your online classes, girls. Why? Because your attendance is captured. I have been telling you, you have to mention your name and class. So whether you're attending the class or not, that is captured by us. And do not hesitate to ask doubts. Okay, let it be any subject, any faculty. You have every right to question them. You have every right to clarify your doubts. And we are there to help you out. All our faculty are very much friendly with you. They'll be very supportive. So you should not have any fear or hesitation from your side. Okay, then whatever assignments, projects, and homeworks that are assigned to you should be completed within the allotted time. Why? Because what happens if you're not able to do it on time, it means that you're not following whatever we are teaching. Okay, so from your side, we want that cooperation. Next thing is, you should revise and practice the topics on the same day. What happens is, moreover, you're not watching any serial, or you're not playing any music on your desktop or phone. You are following the chapters. Okay. So it is a must for you to revise the topics, to go through the topics, whatever is taught on daily basis. Okay. Then I want parents to even monitor you all. Okay. Because it is online and monitoring is very important from parental side. Like whatever timetable you prepare for your studies, because the timetable which we sent is only the timetable for the classes. But I need from your side what you all are doing for studies. Once you start your classes, then your journey starts. You have to take up this challenge. So prepare from your side, prepare a timetable for all the classes, what topics you are going to study on daily basis. You schedule the topics, you discuss with the parents so that even parents will got to know what is going on, whether you are attentive or not, whether you are following it or not. Because we are putting our efforts, though it is virtual, but the same cooperation is required from your side to make it a success, to get good results. Okay, so whatever is your plan, do it accordingly, discuss with the parents, show it to them, then it is very much appreciated. Then about the textbooks, once the classes starts, our faculty members will inform you, will guide you what all textbooks you need to buy. Okay, so textbooks, mostly it is like Telugu Academy, and you won't face any problem in buying those textbooks. It will be available in the market. And like apart from textbooks, you need to have study materials, and that will be provided by us. No matter it takes some time, because it is now prepared by the faculty. They are like on this job. So once it is ready, we'll intimate you like which date and all, so that you can come and collect the material. So most probably it will be next month. And one more request from my side is the students who are in sports, okay, and extracurricular activities, like at state level or national level or international level, please share your details with the faculty in charge of WhatsApp groups, because we should know how talented our students are. Okay, if you come up with your details, then only we are able to get it. Next thing is you can download the e-prospectus. Okay, prospectus that is there in Bhadruka Junior College website. You can download the prospectus so that you will know what our college is. Okay, so if you see our website, you got to know more details of our college, and you can have the contact number also, like landline as well as mobile number. It is there in the prospectus. And apart from that, like if you excel in academics and co-curricular activities of our college in this academic year or second year, like you will be awarded trophies and cash awards. So your talent, the way you expose, and if you excel in those fields, definitely we appreciate and you will be rewarded for the same, let it be academics or extracurricular. Okay, and next is for any queries, if you have related to your studies or anything, you can contact us on phone, or else you can also come in person and meet us. We all are available, office people, faculty and all, we all are available from 10 to 4. So if anything is required from our side, our support is there for you people. So girls, once again, I wish you all the luck. Good luck for your studies, and be serious towards your studies, no matter if it is offline or online. Repeatedly, our support will be provided, but your cooperation is equally important. Okay, so I'll end up with this. Thank you very much, and over to Jyoti ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
That was very informative, is it not, girls?
Ma'am.
Information, yes, ma'am. So that you can very easily, without any doubts, you can start the classes on Monday. Okay, so now we have our vice principal ma'am, Deepa ma'am. She is the Hindi faculty here, and she is one of the most caring people that I have met. Definitely when you come see her online, or when you come to college, whenever that is, you will know that she takes so much of personal care for each and every student, especially the ones who are involved with her, because she is the Hindi faculty. She will be dealing with the Hindi students. Over to you, Deepa ma'am.
Okay, thank you so much, Jyoti madam.
Thank you so much. Good morning, dear students.
Good morning, ma'am.
कैसे हो आप सब लोग? वैसे तो आज तीसरा दिन है हमारी मुलाकात का, तो ज्यादा परिचय देने की जरूरत नहीं है मुझे, कम शब्दों में ही मैं आपको बोल दूंगी क्योंकि आज तीसरा दिन है और जितना बोलना था हमारे प्रिंसिपल मैडम ने आपको सब कुछ बता ही दिया है। तो जैसे जैसे हम लोग मिलते रहेंगे, क्लासेस होते रहेगी, परिचय बढ़ता रहेगा, आपसी मेलजुल रहेगा, तब मैं आपको और बताते रहूंगी। आज आपका थोड़ा सा समय लेकर बस थोड़ी सी बातें मैं आपको बताऊं, ठीक है?
ठीक है।
वैसे आपको पता है ज्योति मैडम ने बोला कि वाइस प्रिंसिपल और हिंदी प्राध्यापिका, मैं आज आपको छोटा सा अपना संक्षिप्त में परिचय देना चाहती हूँ। तो पिछले 16 वर्षों से मैं शिक्षा के क्षेत्र में हिंदी शिक्षिका के रूप में अपना योगदान देते आ रही हूँ। पिछले 16 वर्षों से मैं ये कार्य कर रही हूँ और इन 16 वर्षों में मेरी यही प्रथम प्राथमिकता रही है कि हिंदी जो हमारी राष्ट्रभाषा है, जो दुनिया भर में बोली जाने वाली सभी भाषाओं में से सबसे ज्यादा बोली जाने वाली तीसरे नंबर की भाषा मानी जाती है। तो इसका जन्म 1000 वर्ष पहले ही हो चुका था, संस्कृत की कोख से, मतलब हिंदी की जननी संस्कृत को माना जाता है। संस्कृत के कोख से हिंदी का जन्म हुआ था और इसे देवनागरी लिपि भी कहा जाता है। संस्कृत को देव भाषा कहा जाता है, तो ये इसकी पुत्री हुई है, संस्कृत जननी है, इसे देवनागरी लिपि कहा जाता है। उस भाषा को, इस देवनागरी भाषा को, इतनी प्यारी राष्ट्रभाषा को पढ़ाने व सरल से सरल रूप में समझाने, हिंदी में छात्राओं का मार्गदर्शन करने, उनको जीवन जीने की कला सिखाने, उनको मानवीय मूल्यों को समझाने में मैं हमेशा अपना योगदान देती रही हूँ और आगे भी देती रहूंगी। विशेषतर लड़कियों को शिक्षा के क्षेत्र में आगे बढ़ाने के लिए हमेशा मैं उनका सहयोग देती हूँ और आगे भी देती रहूंगी, भगवान से मेरी यही प्रार्थना। तो आप लोगों ने जैसे कल सुना भी था कल का, तो हमेशा हम स्टूडेंट्स के साथ रहते हैं, ऐसा नहीं है कि 2 वर्ष हो गए तो आपका और हमारा संबंध खत्म हो गया। 2 वर्ष नहीं, हमेशा जब भी आपको हमारी जरूरत है हम हमेशा आपके साथ खड़े रहेंगे।
ब्रेक वाला सर,
जैसे कि कहते हैं ना, मैं आपको ये सब समझाने के लिए, मेरा ये सौभाग्य है, बड़ी बात नहीं है, ये मेरा सौभाग्य है कि मैं लड़कियों को आगे बढ़ाने के लिए प्रेरणा देती हूँ, उनका मार्गदर्शन करती हूँ। इससे पहले भी मैंने बोला है विशेषतः लड़कियों को आगे बढ़ाने में मेरा बहुत सहयोग होता है। कहते हैं ना, शिक्षक चलते दीप सा, शिक्षा उसका नूर। शिक्षक का नूर क्या है? शिक्षा देना। उसकी सुंदरता क्या है शिक्षक की? उसका बच्चों को शिक्षा देना, उनका सही मार्गदर्शन करना। अंधकार अज्ञान का करते ज्ञान से दूर। सिर्फ मैं ही नहीं, पूरे जितने भी शिक्षक है सभी अपने जलते द्वीप से अंधकार में गए विद्यार्थियों को ज्ञान रूपी दर्शन कराते हैं, ज्ञान रूपी मार्गदर्शन कराते हैं। इसलिए सिर्फ मैं ही नहीं, मेरा पूरा स्टाफ, पूरी फैकल्टी जितने भी हैं, सभी आपको पूरा पूरा साथ दें। और ये भी कहते हैं ना, माँ देती है जन्म हमें, शिक्षक देते ज्ञान। मम्मी को हम पहला गुरु मानते हैं अपना, माँ हमारी पहली गुरु होती है, चलना उठना बैठना सिखाना बात करना सब कुछ हमें माँ सिखाती है। इसीलिए माँ देती है जन्म हमें, शिक्षक देते ज्ञान। पिता से मिलता नाम है तब बनती पहचान। मतलब आपको आगे बढ़ाने के लिए, आपके जीवन को आगे बढ़ाने के लिए, आपको आपके लक्ष्य तक पहुंचाने के लिए सिर्फ शिक्षक ही नहीं, गुरु ही नहीं, माता पिता गुरु तीनों का साथ होना बहुत जरूरी है और तीनों बराबर में आपको साथ देते। लेकिन उनका साथ पाने के लिए हमें भी उनके लिए कुछ करना जरूरी होता है, हमें भी उनका साथ देना बहुत जरूरी होता है। जैसे वे हमें बताते हैं उन संस्कारों पर चलना बहुत जरूरी होता है। जीवन में पढ़ाई तो सब है ही, लेकिन उसके साथ साथ हमें व्यवहारिकता होना बहुत जरूरी है। अगर हम पढ़ लिख कर व्यवहारिकता नहीं है तो वह पढ़ाई लिखाई कोई काम की नहीं है। बिहेवियर हमारा बहुत अच्छा होना जरूरी है। क्लास टॉपर हो लेकिन बात करने का ढंग नहीं है तो कोई मतलब नहीं है। इसीलिए पढ़ाई के साथ साथ बुनाई का होना बहुत जरूरी है, अच्छे संस्कारों गुणों का होना बहुत जरूरी है। समझ रहे हो गर्ल्स? समझ में आ रहा है मैं जो बोल रही हूँ?
जी मैम।
मेरी सफलता का प्रमाण इसी बात से मिलता है कि पिछले 16 वर्षों से मेरे द्वारा शिक्षित किए गए भद्रुका कॉलेज में हमेशा हिंदी का रिजल्ट 100% रहा। एक भी लड़की फेल नहीं होती है, 100% रिजल्ट रहा है, जिनमें से 30-35% 30-35% स्टूडेंट्स 100 में से 99 अंक प्राप्त करते हैं। आउट ऑफ 199 मार्क्स 30-35 स्टूडेंट्स को हमेशा आते हैं, और यही मेरी सफलता की पूंजी है और यही मेरी सबसे बड़ी उपलब्धि है जो आप लोग मेरा इतना साथ देते हो। इसके लिए मैं आप सभी का और हमारे पास आउट स्टूडेंट्स का बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद अदा कर। आप भी उन्हीं के नक्शे कदमों पर चलने की कोशिश करिए, जरूर आप आपके जीवन में सफल होंगे। मेरा एक मानना यह भी है कि पढ़ाई को कभी बोझ समझकर नहीं पढ़ना चाहिए, बर्डन नहीं लेना चाहिए कि हमको अब पढ़ना ही है क्या करेंगे, नहीं, कभी उसे बोझ समझकर नहीं पढ़ना चाहिए, मनोरंजक के रूप में उसे पढ़ना चाहिए, हंसते खेलते पढ़ना चाहिए। कभी मूवी देखने जाना है तो जाना ही पड़ेगा, ऐसे नहीं सोचते ना, बड़े एंजॉय, बड़े खुशी से प्रफुल्लित होकर जाते हैं, तो ठीक पढ़ाई को भी उसी तरह मनोरंजक रूप में लेकर पढ़ना चाहिए, और यही हमारी सबसे बड़ी व्यवहारिकता है। जैसे हम अच्छा पढ़ेंगे व्यवहारिकता बढ़ेगी। व्यवहारिकता क्या है? सबसे मीठी वाणी बोलिए, विनयशील रहिए, प्रेम पूर्वक रहिए, जैसे बड़े हमें कहते हैं उनके बातों का आचरण कीजिए, ये व्यवहारिकता है। ये सब हमें हमारी हिंदी, हमारी राष्ट्रभाषा, हमारी मीठी भाषा हमें सिखाती है। हिंदी है क्या? एक व्यवहारिक भाषा, व्यवहारिकता सिखाती है और कुछ भी नहीं है। जीवन जीने की कला सिखाती है, जीवन में कैसे आगे बढ़े, बड़ों से कैसे बात करे। जैसे आप विनय पूर्वक रहोगे, सबसे विनयशील रहोगे, प्रेम पूर्वक रहोगे, तो अपने आप आगे बढ़ते जाओगे। एक उंगली कभी आगे नहीं बढ़ सकती है, कोई काम नहीं कर सकती है। सिर्फ पढ़ाई आ गई तो कुछ नहीं, उसके साथ संस्कार, व्यवहारिकता, सब कुछ होना, अच्छा चरित्र होना, चरित्र का निर्माण होना बहुत जरूरी है। तो ये पूरी मुट्ठी बहुत काम की है, 5 उंगलियां मिलकर बहुत काम कर सकती है, एक अकेली उंगली कुछ काम नहीं कर सकती है। तो सिर्फ पढ़ाई लिखाई नहीं, बार बार मैं ये बात आपको समझा रही हूँ, पढ़ाई लिखाई के साथ अच्छे चरित्र का निर्माण करना बहुत जरूरी है। तुलसी मीठे वचन दे, सुख उपजत चहु और, वसीकरण यह मंत्र है, परिहर वचन कठोर। हमेशा हर एक से मीठी वाणी बोलना चाहिए। दोहा बोलने का तात्पर्य क्या है? मुझे दोहा आता ही, आपने दोहा पढ़ा है, और इस दोहे का तात्पर्य यह है कि सभी से मीठा बोलना है। नहीं, तुलसीदास जो प्राचीन कवि भक्तिकाल के है, तब से चला रहा है, हिंदी में ही तुलसीदास है, और वो बता रहे हैं कि हमें लोगों से कैसा व्यवहार करना चाहिए, मीठा व्यवहार करना चाहिए, कटु वचनों को छोड़ देना चाहिए, तभी हम आगे जल्दी से जल्दी अपने लक्ष्य को हासिल कर सकते। एटीट्यूड नहीं रखना चाहिए, एटीट्यूड घमंड जब आ जाएगा तो आप, कभी ईगो जब आ जाएगा तो आप आगे नहीं बढ़ोगे। हमें अपने आप को हमेशा छोटा बनाकर रखना चाहिए। हम बड़े हो गए, मैं की भावना, अहम की भावना जहां आ गई, वहां हमारा जीवन का रुकावट आ गई, ये समझ लेना है। जैसे अहम की भावना जब तक नहीं है, आप रफ्तार से अपने जीवन में आगे बढ़ते रहोगे। क्लियर गर्ल्स? हर माँ अपने बच्चों को अच्छे से अच्छे संस्कार सिखाना चाहती है, सिखाती है, अच्छी से अच्छी बातें सिखाना चाहती है। कोई माँ ये नहीं चाहती है कि हमारे बच्चे हमसे पीछे रहे, हर माँ ये चाहती है कि जहां मैं खड़ी हूँ उससे ज्यादा आगे मेरे बच्चे बढ़े, जो मैंने हासिल नहीं किया है वो मेरे बच्चे हासिल करें। तो सिर्फ माँ, हम आपके सेकंड माँ, हम यहाँ पर जितने भी हैं आपके सेकंड मदर्स है, तो हम भी यही चाहते हैं कि हम जहाँ खड़े हैं हम तो यही रहेंगे, लेकिन हमारे बच्चे हमसे और 4 नहीं 8 गुना आगे बड़े, तरक्की करे, और हम यहीं बैठे कहे कि वो जहाँ उस पोस्ट पर बैठी है वह हमारी छात्रा है, वह मेरी स्टूडेंट है। बड़े गर्व के साथ कहे कि ये लड़की, ये जो नाम है, जो भी नाम है, रेशमा, सुनीता, प्रिया, ये मेरी स्टूडेंट है। तो ये सब करने के लिए आपको मेहनत करनी है, लगन से मेहनत करनी है, परिश्रम करना है, और अच्छे संस्कारों को प्राप्त करना है, व्यवहारिकता लाना है अपने जीवन में, और उसके साथ साथ पढ़ाई भी करनी है, तब जाकर आप आगे बढ़ सकते हो। और हमेशा हम आपके में ही नहीं, हम सभी आपके साथ हमेशा आपका साथ देंगे। क्लियर गर्ल्स?
यस मैम।
क्लियर। अंत में मैं आपसे बस इतना ही कहना चाहती हूँ कि 14 सितंबर को हिंदी दिवस मनाया जाए, याद है सभी को?
हाँ मैम।
14 सितंबर 1949 को व्यवहार राजेंद्र सिन्हा के 50वें जन्मदिन के पर संविधान सभा द्वारा हिंदी को भारत की आधिकारिक और राष्ट्रीय भाषा के रूप में मान्यता प्राप्त हुई थी। तो इसीलिए हर वर्ष 14 सितंबर को हम हिंदी दिवस मनाते हैं। इसे बचाना, इस हिंदी को बचाना, इस भाषा को बचाना, इसे बढ़ावा देना हम सभी का कर्तव्य बनता है। मैं दीपारानी अवस्थी आपकी अपनी पूरी निष्ठा और ईमानदारी से अपने विषय यानी हिंदी विषय को अपनी पहली प्राथमिकता के रूप में निभा रही हूँ और आगे भी निभाती रहूंगी, और अपनी प्रिय छात्राओं को हमेशा उनका अच्छे से अच्छा मार्गदर्शन करती हूँ। और मैं आपसे वादा करती हूँ कि हमेशा मैं आपका अच्छे से अच्छा मार्गदर्शन करती रहूंगी। इन्हीं शुभकामनाओं के साथ मैं आपसे विदा लेती हूँ। बाय। विश यू ऑल द बेस्ट। गुड लक गर्ल्स।
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Deepa, ma'am. This is really wonderful. You took the students on a wonderful journey of Hindi. Thank you so much. Now we have the Sanskrit faculty, Anusha, ma'am. Over to you, Anusha, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
Am I audible to you?
Yes, you are. Please continue.
गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, सर्वेषां शुभोदयः, नमस्ते भाई, सभापतिभ्यश्च नमो नमः।
मॉर्निंग मैम।
नमो नमः। गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स।
स्टूडेंट्स प्लीज म्यूट योर फोन्स एंड व्हेनेवर यू वांट टू टॉक यू अनम्यूट एंड देन अगेन गो बैक टू म्यूट प्लीज। ओके कंटिन्यू मैम।
यस मैम। मम नाम अनुषा, अहम् उस्मानिया विश्वविद्यालयतः स्नातकोत्तर कक्षा समाप्य इदानीम् अत्र कलाशालायाम् अध्यापिक वृत्तिम् अगच्छन् अस्मि। ओके, आई एम गोइंग टू स्पीक इन इंग्लिश बिकॉज आई नो दैट यू डिडंट गेट इट। गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
रेस्पेक्टेड द डिग्निटरीज, माय कोलीग्स एंड माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, I would like to give a brief introduction about the importance of Sanskrit language. Ajnana timirandhasya jnananjana shalakaya chakshur unmilitam yena tasmai shri gurave namaha. This sloka is related in respecting of our lecturers or gurus or parents, everyone. This sloka signifies the role of the guru who removes the blindness of ignorance caused by ego through the use of medicine called language, knowledge. Okay. Sanskrit language is the oldest and the most spoken language since the ancient times. It is the mother of many Indian languages. Most of the languages derives their origin from Sanskrit language. As Deepa ma'am said, Sanskrit languages is the language of gods, It is also called as Amara Bhasha. It is believed that it is the most systematic and technical language of all, and it is in high demand all over the world. Many countries respect our Sanskrit language, and in Germany, Sanskrit is a mandatory subject in every school. Recently, Union government formulated a new education policy for students in which Sanskrit language is included in schools, in every school and in the curriculum. That's the importance of Sanskrit. There are numerous words, numerous synonyms for each word in Sanskrit language. Whatever we speak in our day-to-day life, that many words are derived from Sanskrit language only. For example, a simple word called love, it has 96 synonyms in Sanskrit language. Many Vedas, Puranas, Jyotishas, scriptures are written in Sanskrit, which helps us to build human values and ethics. By reading and writing this language, our IQ level will be increased. It also improves our brain functionality, and it also increases our calculation capacity. Basically, the word Sanskritam means Samyak Krite Iti Sanskritam. Samyak means good things. Kritam means done. Good things are done by Sanskrit language, and good things are taught by Sanskrit language, and it also helps us to mold our way in a good manner. It helps us to think positive and be positive. And you may, students, you may get some doubts about what I've spoken, like what is this God's language, or will I be able to learn this language or not? But please don't think in that way, because Sanskrit language, that whatever your mother tongue is, like Hindi, Telugu, and many other languages, etc., are derived their origin from Sanskrit language. It is an ancient language, but if you put some interest in this, it is the most beautiful language. We can learn it easily if we love it. Okay. Basically, I'm a life sciences student, life science background student, but out of interest, I have chosen this subject. And I've written my OUPGCET exam in Sanskrit, and surprisingly, I got state 13th rank, and I finished my post graduation with good CGPA successfully. After learning this Sanskrit language, my patience level and positivity increased. You can take me as a live example. I've changed so much after learning Sanskrit. And don't worry about anything. I'll make sure that you will learn it easily, as you are very, very energetic and highly talented people with fresh minds. You can learn it as simple as that. By learning this language, your IQ level will be increased definitely, and you will be capable of learning anything in your future. I promise you that I'll make it as simple as that. I'll be very friendly with you. Thank you, ma'am. Thanks for giving this opportunity to speak with our Bhadruka family and my dear lovely students. Thank you, everyone. Dhanyavada.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Anusha, ma'am.
Okay, now we go on to the political science department. What do I say about the political science department? We have a very talented, very experienced, very senior faculty. And the word which is aptly suits her is popular. She is very popular among the students, loved by the students. I'm sorry, MSc girls, you're definitely going to miss her. the CC girls, the political science students, are going to have a treat in her classes. I'm sure you'll enjoy her classes. Over to you, Sharda ma'am.
Thank you so much, Jyoti ma'am. Good morning to all the dignitaries, my faculty members, and my beloved students. This is Sharda here, Department of Political Science. And more than 35 years of experience, I've completed my PhD in the year 1987. Since then, I've been working as political science or civics lecturer. Actually, we will call it as a civics, but not political science. Political science, but not civics. Nowadays, we are calling it as political science. Earlier, we used to call it as civics. I, not only to the student, I always feel that, you know, every teacher, as long as they are in their service, every day is a learning day. Every day is a learning day to a teacher. I feel strongly that that is the reason why every day I would like to update my knowledge. And I would like to learn something or the other new every day. I will never sleep without learning anything on any day. So this is my motto. And the second one is, I strongly believe that education is compulsory and must for a girl child. Not like olden days. These days, education is compulsory because, you know, because of the cost of living or because of the living conditions or anything, you know, both wife and husband, means mother and father, must earn. Otherwise, it's very, very difficult to survive. So definitely, I feel that education is compulsory. I strongly support education to a girl child. Never think about marriage. Marriage is secondary. The first part is education and career oriented. So this is my another motto. And I would like to tell the importance of a political science subject to you. And some students, they'll feel that, oh, you are in CEC, I am in MEC. See, nothing like that. Both MEC students and CEC students, both are having same kind of opportunities. There they are learning mathematics, here you are learning political science subject or civic subject. CEC means civics, economics and commerce. And here I would like to tell you some of the opportunities when you are a CEC student. You can pursue civil services, Indian administrative services. Most of the aspirants, they are choosing political science subject because political science subject is a scoring subject, very interesting subject. I'll tell you, how can you say that civic subject is an interesting subject? Because you being a citizen of India, you should know what is what. What is state? If I ask a question to a student, state means Tamil Nadu or Karnataka or Telangana state. No, according to political science subject, state means the country. Then in this context, I would like to enhance the knowledge of the students. Then I would like to ask a question to the students that since so many years you have been celebrating Independence Days, is it not? Since so many years you have been celebrating from your childhood till now, you have been attended so many Independence Days. Then I would like to know what is Independence Day and what is Republic Day. Any one of you can answer? One after the other, what is Independence Day? First, what is Independence Day?
Ma'am, can
ma'am,
I?
Sure. Anyone?
The day when our country got independence from the British.
Yes, our country got independence. That is why it is known as Independence Day. Yes, anyone can answer what is Republic Day? How many Republic Days?
When we got our own Indian constitution.
We wrote our own constitution.
Yes. Then why not it is Constitutional Day? Why it is Republic Day then?
Because by writing our constitution, we became Republic.
What is Republic then?
The state, the head is the president.
So president day? Is it a president day?
Prime Minister is the head of a country, but on the Republic Day,
Constitution came into power.
Then why not it is Constitutional Day? You are saying that
because
it is
Constitution Day is the day on which day the Constitution was completed. It was on 26th November.
Yes,
but
exactly.
On Republic Day, actually, we were going to get independence before, but we didn't get on that day. So on that day, we made it as Republic Day because on that day we started it as the Constitution came into power.
Then why not Then why not it is Constitutional Day? Why it is called as Republic Day then?
Because India became a republic on that day.
What is republic then? That is the importance of political science subject. That is the importance of civics. That you will understand now. You will clearly understand what is Republic Day, what is Independence Day, what are the terms in India. Like, you know, what is Republic Day? You are saying Constitutional Enforcing Day. It is correct. You are saying that, yes, Republic means Ganatantra in Hindi. Ganatantra is nothing but elections. Republic Day is nothing but from that day onwards, the representatives of India are elected either directly or by indirectly. That is why this is known as Republic.
Same
Republic means request all the students to keep in view. I request all the students to keep in view. Hello? Hello? I request all the students to keep your audio in mute, ma'am. Yes, I am continuing. What is Republic Day? You are good. Republic Day is nothing but on that day onwards, we have started our representatives by the public. Public are going to elect the representatives. That is why it is known as Republic Day. Republic Day is nothing but by election, we are getting our representatives. That is the importance of civics. Definitely, you all will feel interesting. And I would like to tell the opportunities when you are a CEC student. What are the opportunities? You can pursue civil services. Civil services, political science subject is very interesting and you will get definitely a very good score and it is definitely very interesting and most of the aspirants will go for either political science or for the public administration or anthropology. And you know, you can pursue law. Those who are interested in law, they can go BA law or ML, BL, ML or LLB, LLM, definitely the civic subject is necessary because you know you will learn constitution, what is constitution, what is government, how the government is existing, what is the system which we have, how the government is functioning, who is our president, how we are getting our president, who is our prime minister. Everybody knows Narendra Modi. Can anyone say how Narendra Modi existed? Can anyone say how we have elected our Narendra Modi ji?
Parliament members are elected prime minister.
See, I am telling you that here, Narendra Modi ji being prime minister, we have elected him directly. It is a direct election, but selected by the majority party members. Yes, the civic subject is going to tell. Being the citizen of India, leave about MEC or CEC, but every citizen must understand what is our government, what is our country, what is how we are getting our representatives, how the system is functioning, everything, elections, just going and casting our right to vote. No, it's not like that. How the election machinery is functioning, who is working, in what level they are working, everything you will be understanding very clearly. And civic subject tells us respecting the law. What is law? Law is not going to punish. Law will punish, leading to violation. If you violate the law, then only you will be punishable. Otherwise, you are not going to punish. So here, the political science subject is useful for pursuing law. And the third one is, you can pursue MBA. You, those who want to go for MBA, both MEC students and also CEC students, both are eligible for going into the MBA course. Those who want to aspire chartered accountancy, yes, definitely CEC students are also eligible to write CPT and IPCC, they are also eligible for chartered accountancy. Don't think that I am CEC, I am dull-headed, I am not intelligent, that is why I did not select mathematics. No, no, it's not like that. Both MEC and CEC, both students are having same opportunities. Nothing difference with the CEC or MEC. And one more thing which I wanted to tell you is your course is CEC. I would like to tell about four C's. The first C which you have to adopt in your life, it is must till the last breath, is your character. Number two, concentration. Concentration is very, very important in our life. Third one is, yes, you should have a career. You should have a goal setting. You should have an understanding about your career. And the fourth C, which I wanted to tell you, is communication. And the fifth one is you yourself. The first one, which I wanted to tell you, is character. Character is nothing but good behavior, having moral values, having ethical values, having good principles. Yes, you should be. Swami Vivekananda, when he addressed in the Chicago, the parliament, religion of parliament in the year 1893, he said that the sisters and brothers of USA, and I am telling you that the Indians are recognized by their character, not by their talent. See how we appear. Outward appearance is not important for us. The inner beauty is your knowledge. Aristotle, the father of political science, he says that always man is a social animal. We are living in the society. When you are living in the society, you should take care of your character. You should take care of your moral values. You should take care of your good behavior. If your behavior is not good, you'll be pinpointed in the society. No. There is a difference between human being and animal. That is only education and knowledge. Because political science father, Aristotle, he said, we are also animals. We are social animals. Because living beings in the society. So being living beings in the society, we are living in the society. So when you are living in the society, you should take care of your behavior. You should follow good moral values. If you don't know, learn from the others. Respect the elders. Learn from the elders. And you should be good in the society. Because being good in the society is a must. So the first point is character. And the second point which I would like to tell is concentration. Concentration is very, very important. Whatever you do, your concentration is necessary. And some students, they say that, madam, jitna padhe to bhi bhul ja rahe. Whatever I learn, I'm forgetting. How can you forget? Are you forgetting the TV serials? Are you forgetting the movies? Are you forgetting the choreography, how they have done? No. Why? Because you are watching it concentratedly. When you are watching it concentratedly, you are not forgetting the movies. You are not forgetting the TV serials. In the same manner, put the same kind of concentration even on your education also. If you learn concentratedly, definitely you will achieve miracles. Never and ever think that I am dull-headed, I cannot read, I cannot learn, only she is intelligent. No, every creation is created by Almighty. How can you degrade yourself? No, every person, your mirror shows a beautiful face to you, a smiling face to you, an intelligent face to you. So never and ever degrade yourself. Always concentratedly study and approach. You should. Third point which I wanted to tell you is, the first one character, the second one concentration. And the third one which I wanted to tell you is career. You should have a career-oriented person. You should have a goal. Realize the importance of education and keep an ambition in your life. Until and work out, day and night, work hard, till you reach that goal. Never and ever discouraged of yourself. You be with optimistic intentions and you see that you will reach your target and the goal. And the fourth one is communication skills. No matter how you are educated, no matter how you are, but if you are not having good communication skills, you stand nowhere. Because after getting so many qualifications, when you appear for the interview, your communication skills plays a vital role. I request all the students, purchase one small dictionary and learn 5 new words from the dictionary every day. You have to learn 5 new words from the dictionary. First one. And second one which I wanted to tell you is, do not be confined only to a syllabus. Only syllabus is not going to give you any knowledge. Read more and more English books. Get more and more knowledge. And usefully use your time to get the knowledge. And I am telling you one more thing. Practice English grammar every day. All these 3 are very important to get good communication. The first one is learn 5 new words from the dictionary. And the second one is read other than your syllabus books in English. And the third one is practice English grammar every day so that your communication skills will be very, very good. So here I said four C's. One, you are in CEC. I am telling four C's. Character, number one. Number two, concentration. Number three, career. Number four, communication. Number five is you yourself should achieve all these things. Then only you will stand in the society well. Otherwise, we stand nowhere if we are not having good communication skills. So I definitely feel that you're all, you are going to accept all these things and you will practice also. And I'm telling you that, you know, students, everything is very easy. Then you
are the break.
Yes, girls, please mute. I'm telling you, girls, everything is very easy when you are busy by learning something or the other. But nothing is easy when you are lazy. Did you accept? Everything is very easy when you are very busy. But nothing is easy when you are lazy. And I definitely expect that all the Bhadrakans, those who have joined here, they all will be active. And they will definitely follow whatever the teachers are guiding it to you. And you will definitely do miracles in your career. And always believe that today is better than yesterday. And hope that tomorrow will be more better than today. So be with optimistic intention. Be with positive intention. Leave all the negative intentions. Never and ever feel that you cannot do anything. Never and ever feel that only others can do. You also can do it. But be on that job. Work hard and do your best. Definitely. Because, you know, God always will support you. And never and ever think that, why God is giving all problems to me only? Why not to the others? No, no. It's not like that. Ups and downs, pains and gains are common in the life. But never get depressed. Our constitution is also saying that we should not deprive of ourselves. We should not deprive of ourselves. You should think that you are the best. You can do the best. So in this context, I would like to conclude to all my students that all the best. Good luck. Your choice is the best choice for selecting Bhadrapa Junior College. Not only to MEC, not only to CEC. I am going to give a message to MEC students also. But all the best to all the MEC students also. Do your best and do your career well. And have a nice day. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, rightly said. Ma'am has rightly said that learning is a never-ending process. It was a wonderful speech by ma'am. So, girls, now we are going to have a short break where you will be listening to the and also seeing the Bhadruka anthem.
చును ప్రతి ఒక దేహం
ఏ మందిరమున జయ జయ హో అని వినిపించును భవిష్యత్ గీతం ఆ దివ్య క్షేత్రమే భద్రుకా మా బంగారు భవితకు వేదిక
ఈ కోవెలలో కాలిడి నక్షణం గుడి గంట కించును ప్రతి ఒక దేహం
Thank you.
భాగ్యమై నడుమ నిలచే భద్రుకా సంస్థానం
నీడని దీక్షకు ప్రతిరూపం నీడిది అందరి పుణ్యస్థలం
ఓ భద్రుకా నీకు వందనం వర్ధిల్లు నీ కీర్తి కలకాలం
కించును ప్రతి ఒక్క దేహం
పరుషములాడని యోగులు మాకు చదువులు చెప్పే గురువులు
విధులను మరువని విబుధులు మదిని వినయము నింపిన విదురులు
అడిగిన తడవుగా తెలియనివి కడు ఓర్పుతో నేర్పే కోవిదులు మా ప్రియనే స్థాలు
ఈ కోవెలలో కాలిడి నక్షణం గుడి గంటై మ్రోగులు హృదయం ఏ నేలను తాకిన మరు నిమిషం పులకించును ప్రతి ఒక దేహం
మెరుగని సమాజం కలసి సాధిస్తామని చాటుదాం
మహనీయులుగా మనుషులనే మలచే అభినవ గురుకులమే మా భద్రుకా విద్యా నిలయం మా అందరి సుందర ఉద్యానం
जो तुम पर दी है मंदिर में वो
Is it clear now, girls?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
There was
yes,
some problem with the audio during the break, so don't worry. We have set it right. We will continue with our introduction of the faculty now. So now we are going to start with the Commerce Department. And in the Commerce Department, we have Himabindu ma'am. What would I say about her? The only word which comes to me is energy. Someone who's always full of energy and always full of enthusiasm to help the students. Okay, girls? So be ready to listen to her. Over to you, Himabindu ma'am.
Thank you, Jyoti ma'am. Thank you.
Continue, ma'am.
So, good morning, girls.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Mute yourself.
Good morning, ma'am.
I'm Himabindu. I will teach commerce for you. And I have been teaching commerce for last 20 years. But you already, because CEC or MEC students, both you will have commerce subject, yes? CEC, Civics, Economics, Commerce, yes? So I will teach commerce for you. So some of you don't know about commerce because someone of you may heard in your CBSE or ICSE. But so many of you don't know the word commerce, but it's very interesting and it's a very scoring subject. So in this second year and the next upcoming degree or in PG, you learn more about commerce. And now from then onwards, after admitting your first year and second year, you'll be called as commerce students. Okay, so entire means throughout your degree or PG or in inter, you learn more about commerce because all subjects plays a very, very important role, especially commerce is means it's having its value because in the sense of scoring and in the sense of concepts and subject and so many new concepts you learn in the subject. Commerce and accounts, you already heard those words, is it right? So accountability means responsibility towards each and every aspect because we are all girls and we are all women. We are all having responsible towards our work. Yes, we will do it in a nice way, in an artistic way. That's why we're all called arts. Yes, art students we are all. Because whatever the things we will do it in a nice way. No mistakes, nothing wrong in it. Is it right? So we will do that work. So that's why we'll call as commerce students or because being a girl child, you'll do that thing. So accounts, we already discussed. So accountability is there. Accountability in each and every aspect of it. So accounts means accountable, responsible towards the subject, responsible towards the class, responsible toward in learning. When you learn more, then you will give more guidances to anyone. Yes? So accountability, that is also important being a student in each and every subject. Because someone of you like some subjects, because that is my favorite subject. This is my favorite subject. Don't think like that. All are good because all will give more scoring for you. All will give good marks for you. Yes? So in accounts, we learn debit and credit. So debit means what you are getting. That is debit. Credit means what gives you, what goes out. That is comes under credit. So you are learning knowledge and that is debit. And you'll give more that will come under credit. So always try to learn new things and that will help you. We will help you in learning new things and new concepts. So that we'll all will discuss in our subject what is business, what is how to college start. Man. So last year, yesterday, you already some your super seniors came. So many new entrepreneurs came and they gave their experiences to you. So in commerce or in accounts, we learn more about how to start a new business. So what are the new enterprises out there? Nowadays, our economy is a service economy. Service economy means, can you know anything about the service sector? Yes?
Yes.
Yes, girls? Anyone? Service enterprises, what are they?
Enterprises come
Service means?
Transportation, communication.
Transportation, teaching, doctors, lawyers, and chartered accountants also comes under service. But they will charge because they will receive their remuneration. But service sector means the entertainment industry, hotel industry.
Ma'am, sorry, not here, ma'am.
So all these will come under.
Girls, please mute yourself.
Come on, all of you girls, mute yourself.
Please mute.
Yes.
Yes.
Hello. Hello.
Continue, madam. Continue. Okay. Babindu, madam, continue.
Okay. Service enterprises means transportation, communication, entertainment industry, and hotel industry, tourism industry. Nowadays, these are all gaining more popularity. And now in this pandemic situation, so many products we are banning from China. So there is a need for the development of those industries. So in our subject, we learn more about that industries or enterprises which are having more importance to develop our economy, because we have to achieve self-sufficiency. So we are being a developing country like we. So we have to develop more goods and services that will be possible only because of development of small industries. So many experiences you heard yesterday by your super seniors. So many entrepreneurs are there. So nowadays, women entrepreneurs are having more importance nowadays. Ivanka Trump, you already heard her name. Yes, Kiran Majumdar Shah. So all these are the famous good Sudha Murthy. So all these are the entrepreneurs, women entrepreneurs are there. So you will learn more about the entrepreneurs through these subjects, in our subject. Okay, so new enterprises. So we can start. What is the procedure? How to start? So what are the new enterprises are there that we all learn about commerce? So if you are having a zeal, if you are having an enthusiasm, so if you are having a interest to stand on your own, so you can start your own enterprise and you'll also become good entrepreneurs like our super senior students. Because there is no, because if you create more employment, then there is no need for you to depend upon any others for employment. You will become self-sufficient and you will earn your own money. So because that things you will acquire from our subject, some ideas you'll get, and whatever you have to do is learning the subject and what you learn. So you share it, that's the better thing, because what we learn, we will develop by sharing only. Is it right? So that things you learn more in our subject. Okay, na? Yes?
Yes, okay, ma'am. Ma'am.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
So yes, means ma'am. Because what we learn, that we have to share. Okay.
So girls, all the other girls, please mute yourself. Lot of disturbance.
Okay. One more thing.
Ma'am, you muted yourself.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. So, in order to learn these things, be regular to the class and maintain regularity and discipline. Both these are very, very important. So, if you are regular, then you will learn so many things, and that will create more interest in learning the things. Okay.
Yes, okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Himabindu, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. I hope I'm sure the students got a lot of knowledge about foreign commerce. Girls, please mute. I'm sure girls learned a lot about commerce, which is a new subject for them. And now we have the other member of the commerce faculty, Chandrakala ma'am, a very loving and caring person. She's very loving and caring towards anybody who comes into interaction with her. And I'm sure you're going to really enjoy her classes. Over to you, Chandrakala madam.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Chandrakala, ma'am, please start. Yes.
Thank you. Hello.
Yes, please start.
Hello, is my voice audible? Yes, Jyoti, yes, madam.
Yes, yes, I can hear you. Okay. Please continue.
Okay. Good morning, everyone. As you are aware that
good morning,
good morning. It's a moment to have a great immense pleasure and honor for me to extend a hearty welcome to all my dear freshers. As you are aware that our management has conducting the orientation program for 3 days. This is the third day of orientation where faculties are giving their introduction regarding their subject. Myself Chandrakala, commerce faculty, working in this field for the last 20 years, have a good experience in the subject, working in all the time in the junior colleges. Okay, coming to our subject, like why you people have selected Bhadruka itself, why not other colleges? There are so many colleges in the market, but still you have selected this platform. Why? Because our college has got a unique importance. Yes? One second. Okay, come back, girls. Our college has got a unique importance that Bhadruka Junior College for Commerce, for girls, commerce and arts. Means it is a unique college where you find subjects of only commerce background. Whether you take MEC or a CEC, in both the courses, commerce subject is a common one. But no other colleges in the Twin Cities who provide exclusively the commerce subjects. So it is a good platform that you have selected this college as a joining in our college, where we train the students theoretically as practically to endeavor in our subject. Okay, and as you have seen yesterday, many of our students, super seniors, alumni who have been successful in their career, the first option of students when I ask in the college, in the class, so what is the main reason that you have selected this course, means students starts telling that, yes, I want to become a chartered accountant. Okay, it is the topmost course in our subject, becoming a chartered accountant. Okay, it is not that easy. The next level is you can go for the cost accountant. Okay, or else you can select as a company secretary. So likewise, depending upon your capability, you can select such courses. Okay, that's why I say that our subject has got a big roots. You can, wherever you go, definitely you will going to excel. So you can become a chartered accountant, cost accountant, okay, can become a company secretary, we call it as a CS, or if you are good, you can become an accountant in the bank. Banking side, nowadays banks are playing very good role, no? It is a very challenging job. Or else you are not successful in all these fields, you can take up a startup. Yes? What is this startup? Yesterday our seniors told, no? Our senior students taking up an entrepreneurship. Isn't it? Startups. Like you have an idea from the childhood. Some students will have an idea. Yes, definitely I will going to do the business in this particular field. Sitting at home or start a consultancy, wherever, with a small finance, nowadays government is encouraging the youngsters to make the startups. Startups is nothing but it is a self-employment for you, and also at the same time you will going to give an employment opportunity to the others. That means you're helping the society also. self-employment is the best employment. Some students from the beginning of their career, the main intention of joining this course is to become an entrepreneur. So that is also one of the routes. Likewise, you find so many routes, and I feel that Bhadruka College is a very good platform, okay, you to excel you in this college. And here the lecturers, all the lecturers will have a minimum 15 years of experience, okay. So definitely they will going to help you shaping in a better way. Okay, coming to our subject, my subject is commerce. I have been taking for both CEC and MEC. The difference what I find between both these students is, like, the commerce has been divided into two parts. One, 50% will be theory, 50% will be accounts. Okay, accounts means it is little bit related to mathematics. So the math students can do. But if the math students also continually doing the math problems, they may get bored. But our subject is such an interesting subject. It is interesting than mathematics. That's why if you ask a CEC student or a MEC student, which is your favorite subject, means they will definitely tell that commerce is our favorite subject. At any time, if they feel bored also, if they just open and do the any accounts problem, definitely they will feel very happy. And it's not like that we don't give the importance to the answers. Like in mathematics, we just give importance to the procedures, formats and all that. Okay. Like coming to this subject, it is very new for the students who are coming from the state syllabus background. Okay, those who are coming from the central syllabus background may be familiar with this subject. They have studied there in 8th standard or 9th standard. But only 10% of the students may be of central syllabus, remaining all are the state syllabus. So I request all the students who are coming from the state syllabus background that they should keenly inculcate this new concept. Here we will going to lay a good foundation. Here you will going to study the alphabets in our subject. So it is very important that from the day one onwards, you need to concentrate our subject. Like rest of all the subjects, you have been studying in your lower classes. But this is a very new subject. You should concentrate more. And it is really interesting. And it is very scoring subject. I can give a guarantee that you take for the MEC, you will have a mathematics both streams. Okay. Economics plus commerce. Coming to the CEC, you have commerce, civics and economics. Wherever you go, the scoring subject is our and it is most interesting. And we definitely, the commerce faculties, make you clear your doubts at any stage. And for us to inculcate this subject, it takes much time because it is a very new and students should get habituated to create interest among themselves. So, till what are the next... Coming to the present contest, now we all are facing this pandemic COVID-19. Yes, in this pandemic COVID-19, buying and selling of goods especially are taking place through online, which is nothing but our subject e-commerce, isn't it? Through e-commerce, with the help of internet, with the having the banking facilities, means I can say that commerce is everywhere. Entire world revolves around the commerce. It is in your home. Definitely your mother will going to plan for your monthly budget. How many expenses she is had every month and how much income she is getting. With that, she has to plan the budget. And your father will going to plan the budget of your family. He said, yes. Hello girls, please mute your devices. Girls, please mute your devices. Still I'm getting disturbance, ma. Okay. So I can say that planning is very important. Planning is one of the function of our subject. Suppose if you are the students or planning to write the exams, revision is very important. You will going to have a schedule that you will going to plan. isn't it? Or the very good example, I can say that you're paying the college fees. For that fees, you have to do the justice to your students. Means you should continue attending the classes, okay, learn the topics, and definitely you should will get a good marks in the exams. So each and everywhere, your father definitely plans for your family, will have a budget, and our central government, state government will have a financial budget once in a year. So wherever you go, definitely there will be an accountability. Just now, however, commerce madam, she said no, accountability is very important. Means how much you are paying for that, whether you are receiving that much service or not, that you have to see. So from your side, what you have to do, you just be sincere and concentrate on the online classes. Okay, these online classes is not new for you. Already, you have already passed with these online classes last 1 year. You finished your SSC. Now it is a second year. Even we, the lecturers, having a good experience. But this online platform, it is new for us. But we had now little bit experience after crossing 1 year. So from your side and we side, even though it is an online class, definitely we will make these online classes fruitful. And here we will have a interaction with the students personally. They can call through the WhatsApp call, and they want to have any, suppose in our subject, it is a very new subject, you may have a lot of doubts. You may text in the WhatsApp and ask the doubts, okay? And regarding, I was telling that e-commerce means electronic commerce, buying and selling of goods and services through online. Almost 80 to 90% of the consumers now in our place, they are what opting these online services, because touchless, contactless you want because of this pandemic. So people are indirectly or forcibly or what having the e-commerce. So that is also our subject. Wherever you go in our general life, okay, if you work in an organization or at home, planning is very important. That is financial discipline, which is very important. That financial discipline, that is nothing but it is the root of our subject. We not only give the importance to our subject, we definitely encourage the students to have the social values among them. And here we have so many co-curricular activities where the students will going to shape into a talented and successful, colorful students when they go out of the institute. Okay. Still, anything regarding our subject, in the first day of my class, again, I'll be questioning that what is the main reason you people have opted only the commerce subject, because there are other subjects like MPC and BIPC are also there, but you could able to answer that why you wish to have these subjects only. Don't say that it is by choice we have taken this subject, because through online we cannot understand that science is subject, that's why we opted. No, our subject has got even a science student may not know our subject, but you people know the science subject, and now you are studying a new subject called as a commerce. Really, it will be a fantastic and really it will be interesting and a scoring subject for you. Okay, last but not the least, I wish all the students to have a happy learning journey ahead here, and you people should be an outstanding stay in our college. Thank you. Thanks a lot. Have a good day.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you for giving the students so much of knowledge about the subject. Okay, now we move on to the next department, that is the maths department, math subject. Everyone is scared of math, right? But we have wonderful lecturers here who can make the journey of these 2 years through maths very easy. They'll sail you through it. So to begin with, we have, please mute.
అంటే మీ ఉద్దేశం కదా ఎందుకు వచ్చింది
గర్ల్స్ ప్లీజ్ మ్యూట్
अरे म्यूटेड मैम
ओके थैंक यू गर्ल्स Now we to begin with we have Usha ma'am, a very simple person, but her depth of knowledge is very great. I'm sure you'll learn a lot from her. Over to you, Usha ma'am. Usha ma'am, waiting for you.
Good morning. Am I audible, madam?
Yes, yes, yes. Please continue.
Good morning to all the faculty members and dear students. A warm welcome to all the freshers on the occasion of beginning of the new academic year. I am Usha Rani. I'm your mathematics lecturer. I did my MSc from Usmania University and I have been teaching mathematics for more than 20 years. Okay. And many feel that mathematics compared to other subjects, mathematics is not that easy. Okay. But I don't agree with this. Okay, I think most of you might have heard of Srinivasa Ramanujan, a great mathematician. He's an Indian great mathematician. Okay,
yes, ma'am.
He did not have any formal education in mathematics, he did his contribution to mathematics is very vast. And one more genius, Shakuntala Devi. I think you might have heard her, and you might have seen the movie also, ma'am. Okay,
yes, ma'am.
And yeah,
yes, ma'am.
She was a wonderful lady, and she did not have any proper degree in mathematics, but she played with mathematics. Okay, so you can take mathematics as something like a puzzles. When you solve the problems, you can feel that you are solving some puzzles, and it increases your capability of thinking, and it activates your brain also. Okay,
yes,
and similar,
ma'am.
Yeah, ma. So you just consider. See here, children. See, whenever you are doing math, don't get scared of your mathematics. Okay, then, so if you love the subject, you will get it very easily. Whenever you love something, you'll get it very easily. Okay, so, and you know, and all of you know, the success, you cannot get success in shortcuts. Okay, there is no shortcut for success. If you work hard, then only you'll be able to get success. Okay, and be sincere with your efforts. And we are there to help you. Myself and one more madam is also there to help you out in all your mathematics classes. Okay, and just let me say one thing, do your maths happily and enjoy your maths classes. Okay, don't feel they are difficult to you. We are there to help you out. Okay, then wishing you all the best. And regarding your maths subjects, we'll discuss in the classes on the Monday. That means in the next class we'll be discussing. And you'll have two in your mathematics, you'll have got two papers. One is maths 1A and other one is maths 1B. One will be handling, I will be handling one paper, and other madam will be handling another paper. Okay. And regarding the subject and all these things, we'll discuss when your classes start. Wish you all the best, children. Hope you'll do
thank
well.
Thank you, ma'am.
Wish you all the best.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thanks over for the short madam. And sweet message to the students. Okay. Now we have the other maths faculty, Geeta ma'am, a very quiet person, but her depth of knowledge is really very great. You will understand once she starts teaching you in the class. Over to you, Geeta ma'am. Geeta ma'am.
Shall I start, madam?
Yes, please.
Yeah. Good morning, girls. Good morning, all of you.
Good morning, ma'am.
I'm Geeta, your maths lecturer, and I have been teaching maths from the year 1999. More than 20 years of experience I have. But now I'm not going to tell anything about maths, ma. Anyway, in the maths class, we will be teaching all those things. But one thing I want to say is, whatever you learn, whatever you do, please do with the joy. Whenever you do with the joy, with happiness, you will get anything, ma. What, madam, in this corona, how can we be joyful? Girls, one thing you remember, joy does not depend on the circumstances. It is within you. It is within you. Whatever you do, please do with joy. It is within you only, ma. And one, I think that this is the beautiful opportunity for you. You are sitting at home in front of the cameras. You are learning the things in front of the cameras. It is a very good opportunity to do all the things that you have not done in your school days, because school timings are from 8 to 5 or something else. So you did not get any time to do all those things that you wanted to do. But now girls are in this corona situation, Bhadruka Junior College, you have only half a day session. So the remaining half a day, you can do whatever you want. Learn music, learn dancing, learn whatever you want. Please do with joy. Whatever you want to do it, ma. Live your life. Live your life. If you do it with joy, no, even maths will follow you. Maths will follow you. If you love the subject, you will get the maths very easily. It is not that hard, ma. It is very easy. But the consistent is very important. Important. You need to do every day. Every day practice is needed. Okay. Whatever we teach in the class. One more thing I want to say here is, even though we have 20 years of experience, every day we will practice the sums and we will come to the class, ma. So I want my children, my students also to do the same thing, so that you can learn the subject more easily, more joyfully. Don't think that maths is a very hard subject. It is a very easy. If you learn it, it is a very, very easy. Anyway, we will make you to learn maths in a very easy way. No doubt in that. Me and Usha madam will do our best. But what we want you people to do is, whatever you do, do it with joy. I'm not telling that every moment, every time you practice only maths sums. I'm not telling that, girls. If you want to help your mother in the kitchen, help her. If you want to do gardening, do gardening. Please mute it, my dear. Mute it, my dear. Pujita. Pujita, mute it. Pujita, mute it, ma. Pujita. Pujita. Dear Pujita. Pujita, will you mute it?
Who is this girl who is not muting? Please mute. You're disturbing everybody else.
Pujita.
Pujita, please.
Okay, ma'am.
Please do it immediately.
Mute it, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Please continue.
Yeah. I welcome you all to Bhadruka Junior College. Here we have excellent faculty, more than 15 years of experience each and every faculty has. So you can learn more. You can learn more other than the subject also. You can learn anything here, ma. So please do your best with the full joy. Please attend the online classes regularly. Do whatever the exercises, whatever the assignments we give in the class, please do it regularly. And learn the formulae. Formulae are very important in maths. So learn the formulae regularly. And it is not the subject that you have learned in your lower classes, ma. It is something else, something beyond that. So you need to be very conscious, very alert in the class. After that, anyway, you have only half a day session, no? So after that, anything you can learn in the class itself. After that, you can do. This is the wonderful period, girls. You can learn what not. Arts you can learn. Painting you can learn in the remaining period, ma, in the remaining half a day period. So do your best, girls. All the best to all of you. And I welcome to Bhadruka Junior College.
Thank you.
Thank you, girls.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, girls, please take care to keep your devices on mute, because, you know, it disturbs not only you, not only me, and so all of us. Okay, now we come to the economics department. And in the economics department, we have a very senior lecturer. She is the senior most in the college. So I'm sure she has a vast knowledge, which will definitely benefit the students. She is Lakshmi ma'am. Over to you, Lakshmi ma'am.
Good morning to everyone.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
I welcome all of you into Bhadrika Junior College. And let me be your economics teacher. So I did my MA economics from Usmania University, and also I completed MPhil also from Usmania University. So I have been working here since more than 25 years. So I have seen so many batches. Year to year, the students' capacity and intelligence, into the intelligence and how they are behaving and how they are grasping the subject and all, I'm seeing that. So I'm very happy. So as the students, that is year to year, the new years are coming, so then I have to teach differently. So different approach I have to take. And I have to see that, so to what extent the subject, I have to make the subject very easy, okay, very understanding with examples.
Ma'am, Pujita, not muted, ma'am.
Pujita, keep your audio mute. Hello, Pujita? Yes, yes. So once again, I welcome you all for this institution. You have chosen very, very nice courses, that is very important courses you have chosen, that is CEC and MSc. CEC means Civics, Economics and Commerce subjects are there. Okay, Civics, Economics and Commerce. So MSc, Mathematics, Economics and Commerce. So economics is common in both the courses, CEC and also as well as in MSc. Economics is common. So myself and Ramalakshmi madam, one more madam is also there, economics madam. So she's also very experienced. So you can take our services to the maximum extent. So we'll help you and we'll see that. So make the subject as very easy, understandable, okay? So still if you are feeling any difficult understanding anything, so I'm here to clarify your doubts and all. So you must understand the subject so that you will feel very happy. Any subject here, till now your many lecturers came and they explained about so how to learn the subjects, so in intermediate level, so that even economics also, you should not, so most of the people they'll say that it's a dry subject, but you should not feel like that. So it's very interesting and very helpful to everyone. So it is day-to-day life, it is connected to day-to-day life. The subject of economics is connected to day-to-day life. So how we have to lose our limited income, right? Economics, what it teaches? I think it may be new to you. Some of you may, that is aware about the subject in CBSE and ICSE students. So they may know about some of the concepts and all. But ICSE students, it may be new to you. To you people, that is. So the subject we can know about, so how we have to spend our limited resources. So it's a subject of social science, so it deals with the choice problem. So how to make choice, how to use our resources. So the different terms, different terms we learn, different concepts we learn. So those concepts and different terms we learn in our class, okay? So we can, from Monday onwards, classes start. So we can, we will tell about what type of, what are the books you have to follow in the class. And you have to maintain the notes. That is running notes you have to follow. If you are not following the running notes in economic subject, it's very, very difficult. Okay. So you must take the points. When teacher is explaining, so you must take the points. So that you need to understand. Okay, it will be more clear to you. So economic subject is very, that is useful to everyone. That is the thing is, the student can understand the policies of the government. So what type of policies the government is making? Why it is, what are the reasons for that? Okay, what are the problems in that policy? Okay, so we can make suggestions and all. So a student can understand, everybody must know about the subject of economics. So that what type of policies, tax policies, and similarly monetary policies, all these policies are on budget, you can understand. So all these things can be possible by having the knowledge of economics, right? Even Prethusel says economics and commerce mostly connected subjects. Okay, even commerce, the producer, businessman can understand and what type of products they have to manufacture and how to get the profits, all these things. So they can understand only if they know about the subject of economics. Demand, supply, all these things, terms you can learn under the subject of economics. Okay, so let me congratulate to all of you for the completion of your school level studies for a period of 10 years. For a period of long period of time.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, compared with your teachers. Now this is, you enter into the Bhadrapa Junior College for Girls. So it's a very esteemed institution. It's one of the important best institution in big cities. Okay. So we are all hoping that we will get good result to the college. Okay. So rank to the college. So the development of the college depends upon the students, the capacity of the student. So overall development of the student is very important. Overall development of the student, Bhadrapa meant for discipline and overall development of the student. So you have to make an effort, maintain discipline, be regular to the college, attend the classes, even though it is online classes. Okay. So you must have some internet facilities and all. Okay. So in economics, first year we have principles of economics, that is microeconomics, and in second year we have Indian economy. Okay. So we learn about what is what type of industries we have, agriculture, why, how to develop agriculture, more goods, how to produce more goods in agriculture, what are the problems and all these things. So we can know about overall economy of the country, how to develop the country or not. Okay. So all the best girls, good luck.
Thank you, ma'am.
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 So I'll discuss more about the subject in the class. Okay. Thank you very much. All the best.
Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thanks for all the advice for the students.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Next we have Rama Lakshmi, ma'am. She's also in the economics department. A very friendly person, and I'm sure, girls, you're going to enjoy her classes. Over to you, Rama, ma'am. Rama, ma'am.
Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Thank you, Jyoti, ma'am. Thank you. So, good afternoon, girls. Good afternoon, all of you, both CEC and ME students.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
First of all, congratulations to all of the girls, those who successfully completed your 10th class, and warm wishes from our institution. And now you are entering into inter, that is inter first year. So, now you became a college student. So, first, congratulations, and I hope that you will enjoy the classes from this institution, and all the lecturers are very highly talented and experienced lecturers here. So, I, Rama Lakshmi, I'll teach economics for you, for MEC students. And here, first of all, due to this pandemic situation, due to corona pandemic situation, we are not able to interact you with you directly. So not able to interact with you directly. So anyway, though we are not interacting with you directly, but I hope that we will give full support to you and you will enjoy all the classes.
1 minute, Rama madam, sorry to interrupt you. There is some disturbance.
Okay, there is some disturbance.
Girls, please mute your devices, please. Okay, ma'am. Continue, ma'am. Yeah. Sorry for the disturbance.
Yes. Okay. It's okay. So, due to this, we are conducting online classes, girls. So, because of these online classes, so you can listen the classes sincerely. You should listen the classes sincerely. And you should attend the classes regularly also. So here I suggest you that please don't misuse these online classes. So please make use of these, please take advantage of these online classes and don't misuse it. So listen the classes regularly and make revision up to date. Means every day you should do revision, you should revise whatever the lecturers are saying. So regarding my subject, so economics, many of them they are of the opinion that it is a tough subject like that. But it is very easy subject, you listen it concentrately. So without concentration, you cannot understand economics, especially first year economics. So please, I request all the girls, please listen the classes regularly, and attendance is important. So attend the classes regularly. And we hope that next year, with the God's grace, next year we may interact with each other. Let us pray to God that we can connect with each other, we can interact directly in the classes, so that it will be more effective for us. So regarding my subject, economics, I think many of them, the basics, I think you have learned in 8th, 9th and 10th classes, I think so. So here economics, inter-economics is somewhat different. So now especially acquiring knowledge in economics is very important in this pandemic situation, because this is the situation where the economic activities are locked down. Means here the growth, the country's financial position is somewhat came down because of this corona situation. So I hope, girls, that we will be out of this situation, and now we are fighting with this invisible situation, invisible enemy. So here I conclude that whatever we are saying in the class, please make a revision, that day-to-day revision is so important. So economics, don't be afraid of economics. Please learn effectively, and as Max Madam said, that you should learn, you should listen the classes with joy and with interest. Then only you can increase your interest in the subject. And here, mainly all the lecturers are experienced, and full support, full cooperation will be there from us. But we want from your side also. So your cooperation is also most important for us. That means here, as because of this corona situation, we are not able to conduct examinations regularly. But don't think only about the examination. So don't think that whether examinations will be conducted or not, don't be in that situation. So please, whatever we are saying, listen carefully and acquire knowledge. Please increase knowledge of every subject. So if you increase your knowledge, that will be useful for you in for further studies. So economics, like civics ma'am said, commerce ma'am said, so these are the subjects which will be helpful for you in competitive examinations. So knowledge, it is wealth, then wealth today it may be with us, or tomorrow it may not be with us, but knowledge, it will be with us only. So here, so don't think about only examination point of view. So listen the classes sincerely, and you should gain knowledge from all the subjects. So that knowledge is important for you girls. So here for further studies. So if you think that if there is no examination in this year, you will feel so happy. But don't think that we are no need to read, no need to study. So please gain knowledge from each and every subject. So that knowledge is useful to you in future. So in this way, girls, I conclude that thank you. Thank you for the faculty, and thank you. Yes. Okay, so all the best, girls, all the best for first year and for second year also, for the completion of this intermediate education in our reputed college. So thank you, girls, and all the best.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thanks for all the advice for the students. I'm sure they have learned a lot. Thank you, now ma'am. Coming to now, so now coming to me. Since morning I have been speaking to you. So who am I? So I will be teaching you English. My name is Jyoti, and I will be teaching you English. English, what is English? The textbook which you are going to purchase, the lessons we are going to cover, the grammar that we are going to do, or is it something else? As far as the student is concerned, I think it is what I mentioned just now. I need to cover the lessons. I need to get the notes. I need to do all the answers in the grammar part of the workbook. Finish all the answers. If I don't get the answers, ask ma'am or get a guide and finish all the answers. And that is the end of my English. Is it so, or is English something else? English is all around us, is it not? Any subject that you are going to study, you are going to study in English. So what we discussed just now is not true. English is not only reading the lessons and doing the grammar. It is much, much more than that. We use English for communication, right? We use it every day, everywhere. In every country, the main language that we use as official language is English. So for me, as a student, is it only the examination point of view or something more? Yes, girls, please come out of that thought process that I need to get so many marks, maybe 99 marks or 96 marks or 90 marks or whatever. Who is that, girls? Who is disturbing again? What is the disturbance? Yes. So, English is the main link language of the world. It is also called the link language of the world. Wherever you go, if you don't even know the local language, you can survive with English. Is it not? So what do I do? How do I improve? Suppose I go to a foreign country and I don't know English properly. What do? I improve my language. And how do I improve my language? I surround myself with the language. How did you learn your mother tongue, girls? Somebody came to you with a textbook, whatever your mother tongue is, whether Hindi or Telugu or anything else. Somebody came with you when you were a baby. Somebody gave you a textbook and said, now learn. Learn Telugu, learn Hindi. It did not happen like that, is it not? You learned your mother tongue because you were surrounded by it. Everyone around you was speaking the mother tongue. So automatically you got it. So very, very easy way is to surround yourself with the language. And how do you surround yourself with the language? You speak the language. You read the language. You listen to it. And you write it. These are the four points which you need to keep in mind for improving your English as a language, not as a subject. Not to just learn grammar, blindly learn grammar. This is a noun, this is a pronoun, this is that. No. How do I learn it as well as I know my mother tongue? I surround myself. I speak, I listen, I write, and I read. These are the four points you need to keep in mind. Sure, short ways of learning English as a language. I won't take much of your time. Whatever else about the language and about the subject, English as a language, English as a subject, we will discuss it in the class. Okay, so now to conclude, I would like to thank Asha ma'am, our principal ma'am, and Deepa ma'am, who is our vice principal ma'am, and all my colleagues who have taken out their valuable time and given it to you students as advice to you students. I hope you students got a lot of information about our college and you learned many things. Yes, we welcome you all once again. From on behalf of all the staff,
thank you, ma'am.
And the principal and the vice principal, I welcome you all to our college. Monday, the classes will start. You will get the links for the classes. Attend the classes regularly, and like principal ma'am said, follow all the points that she has mentioned to you, so that very successfully, very easily, very joyfully, without any tensions, without any problems, we can complete your this course of intermediate first year followed by intermediate second year. Thank you, girls. Thank you so much.
Thank you,
girls.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
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 What happened, Professor?